Rivers transform the landscape as they flow through on the journey from source to sea. They shape valleys, create waterfalls, meanders, and other distinct landforms. Let's take a look at how a river is formed and journey downstream through the upper, middle, and lower courses using the River Severn, the UK's longest river, as our case study. The place where a river begins is called the source. Typically found in highlands, a river starts its journey hundreds, sometimes thousands of meters above sea level. It's a region that receives high annual rainfall, glacial runoff, or both. So, all this water needs to go somewhere. High up in the upper course, thousands of tiny streams of water come together to form what becomes the river. Pulled downhill by gravity, the water seeks lower ground and ultimately reaches sea level. Now, while doing this, the water erodes a channel into the landscape that the river then flows along. Rivers are nature's drainage system, and on the journey from source to sea, a river continues to collect water. The area of land drained by a river and its tributaries is the drainage basin. A watershed is the ridge of land on the border of a drainage basin that separates it from adjacent basins. Determining whether rain and runoff flow into one river system or another depends on which side of a watershed it falls on. Looking at the River Severn, the watershed, highlighted here along the highland ridges, marks the rim of its drainage basin. The River Severn drains an area of 11,266 square kilometres. Within a river's drainage basin, tributaries, small rivers and streams, also feed water into the main river. Some major tributaries of the River Severn are the rivers Stour, Teme and Wye. The point where each of these tributaries join the Severn is known as a confluence. Now then, the course of a river can be divided into three parts: the upper, middle and lower courses. The River Severn's source is on the northeastern slopes of the Plinlimmon Hills in the Cambrian Mountains, Powys, Wales, and where we begin our journey downriver. It begins around 600 metres above sea level, in one of the wettest parts of Britain, where the annual rainfall is more than 2,500 millimetres. Here in the Welsh Hills, water from the low pressure systems that roll in off the Atlantic bring heavy rainfall to blanket peat bogs like this. In the upper course, fast-flowing water during high rainfall events causes large-scale erosion to occur, creating landforms such as waterfalls, gorges, and interlocking spurs. The valley floor is narrow with steep sides, creating a valley. V-shaped valleys, typically found in the upper course of a river, are formed by vertical erosion. As water cuts deep into the landscape, it creates the steep sides and narrow valley. The power of vertical erosion is highlighted by the River Severn's steep descent from the source to the Welsh town of Llanidloes. In just 17 kilometres, the river drops from 600 to 150 metres above sea level. Leaving the river's upper course, the landscape becomes less rugged and mountainous. By the river's middle course, the volume of water has increased, the river is wider, and the land tends to become flatter. The middle course of the River Severn starts around Shrewsbury. In the middle and lower courses, the process of lateral erosion rather than vertical erosion is dominant, forming wide, deep valleys with gently sloping sides, as well as meanders, and through flooding, oxbow lakes. By the time we reach the lower course, the final stage of a river, the landscape is almost flat. the channel is at its widest and deepest. In the lower course of the River Severn, which begins around Tewkesbury, the channel stretches to 70 metres wide. The discharge of a river is a measurement of the volume of water flowing past a particular point over a unit of time, measured as cubic metres per second. Boasting the biggest river discharge of the UK rivers, the River Severn peaks at a flow of 107 cubic metres per second near Gloucester. River landforms found mainly in the lower course include floodplains, levees, and estuaries, which have been formed by thousands of years of lateral erosion. Lateral erosion continues widening the river as it approaches the sea or another body of water. The River Severn's journey ends around southwest Gloucestershire, where it becomes the Severn Estuary. It's technically no longer considered a river because it's become a coastal water body where sea tides and the river merge. The Severn Estuary flows into the Bristol Channel and then into the Celtic Sea, where our journey ends.
If you like this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.